Hello everybody and welcome to the channel that became an airship. Now it will never sink. Ha ha ha. This time, I'm shifting my focus away from RPGs and going to RTS. This may make it easier for me to get videos out faster, so I don't really think in a RTS. I just do it when I see an opportunity. While I set up a game, I'll talk about it. Rise of Legends is from the creators of Rise of Nations. As you may guess, the mechanics are going to be very similar. Sands advancing through human history. Instead of building cities, you capture them through trade or conquest, and you construct districts to empower them. Each of the three factions gets a military and a trade district, and each get a unique district. The three factions are, the Vinci with their might of steam and steel. The steampunk faction. Simply the most OP of the three factions with its ability to cheapen and quicken technology and construction, along with a buy and sell resource function. The second is the Aline, the magic nation. They are typically weak, but are very good at producing infantry on the fly and inducing a debuff called glass corruption. Fire, sand, and glass are the Aline's magic, with glass corruption permanently cutting enemy HP in half. And finally, there's the Coatl, the science fiction nation. They are the hardest nation to learn, and can be strong defensively and offensively. Their buildings have a shield around them, and many of their units, heroes especially, can cause fire and plague damage over time. I also use the Vinci, and it's this game's entire fault that I eventually developed an interest in steampunk. If I can get a steampunk version of my avatar, I will always use that. My opponents are always the Coatl. I enjoy the challenge they can pose, as their damage over time can bypass invulnerabilities, which the Vinci have access through Giacomo, the inventor of Mayana. And then I use a 30-minute piece timer to build up, but I'll speed that up a bit. Okay, I'm good to go. Once the game begins, I won't include commentary. But maybe some comments every once in a while. One problem with having more than one Coatl in a game is they both use their unique power at the same time, causing intense lag for the duration.
Thank you. Thank you.
And there you have it. No matter what sort of disadvantage I find myself in, the Vinci are capable of turning it around. Having access to a way to trade resources is what makes the Vinci so powerful. But those graphical glitches were new, I've never seen that before. That's it for today's video. If you liked it, fly your gyrocopter into that like button and drop a comment down below if you want to see more Rise of Legends, or you can suggest a different RTS game for the next video. A list of what RTS games I have are in the description below, but some of what I have includes, but are not limited to: Age of Empires 1, 2, and 3, Rise of Nations, World of Conflict and the Soviet Assault Expansion, Sins of a Solar Empire and the original Warcraft 3. Until next time, bye bye.